الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا متعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا اللهم ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا رب العالمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وعنا معهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him. And he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah that we do bear witness that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. كأنه عليك أنزل part 2. As if it was revealed to you part 2. Few weeks ago I did a khutbah with this title. كأنه عليك أنزل. What do I mean? The miraculous stories of the Quran in light of what we face in our time. Quran is a book of guidance. And whenever, wherever, whatever you are facing, regardless, you will find an answer for something that you are facing in the Quran. That's why one of the wisdoms behind why it's highly recommended to keep reading and having a word of the Quran all the time, because the Quran is a book of guidance. It's a general book of guidance. Guidance for what? Solutions. What to do, what to say, how to think, how to understand what's happening. And I believe most of us, we are in one of the most difficult times maybe in the history of humanity now. Not because of the number of killing, no. Because maybe the Mughals, maybe they killed more. Maybe the Crusaders killed more in one day in Jerusalem hundreds of years ago. The idea that we have the tools, we have the facilities, we are an eyewitness directly, and we are doing nothing. This is the mind-blowing. Sometimes, by the way, hundreds of years, sometimes even the Khalifa himself, when he passed away, some people, they know about the death of the Khalifa 6 months later, 4 months later. They don't know. Now, we are witnessing the direct killing of innocent civilians on spot by second life. Yet, with all of these powers, with all of these claimed slogans of human rights, you know, this kind of international community, this kind of treaties, everything is just, as we say in Arabic, just an ink on a paper, nothing at all. So, people like us, I mean by us, the normal people, we are not a people of authority. We don't have armies, we are not politicians, we don't have this kind of power, we don't own the media, we are just normal people. In addition to dua, definitely, we all make dua. What can we do? at least to understand from Islamic point of view the general picture, at least, which is spreading awareness. This is what I'm trying to do, just to try to excuse myself when I stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the least, by the way, because can you imagine if everything is happening now and we don't understand what, when, how? This is another disaster, at least from faith point of view. I'm not addressing now politicians. I'm not addressing. If there we have politicians here who have the decision makers, completely I will address them with something else. If I'm talking with leaders now, may Allah let them, every one of them, especially Arabs and Muslims, to face what he deserves in this dunya before the akhirah. So I'm addressing just people like myself who are just, you know, our hands are cuffed, literally. I mean, as I said, we don't own the mainstream media, we don't own the military power to try to stop the atrocities against the oppressed people. We just watch, type. At least let's understand. Let's understand. I keep repeating, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَقْصُصُ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Narrate to them stories of the past, so perhaps they will reflect. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. In another ayah. In their stories, there is truly a lesson for people of reason. This message cannot be fabricated, rather. It's a confirmation of the previous ما كان حديثا يفترى. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to narrate the stories, to tell about this, so that what? يتفكرون. So that we might be able to reflect upon and to have a عبرة, a lesson. Listen from what? As we say, we are people of faith. Our story has not been finished yet. As people of faith, death is not the end. It's the beginning of another stage. If we know that, and as people of faith, we need always to be aware of the following. We have three main stages in our lives. If I be more accurate, four main stages. Stage number one, when our souls are created in the unseen, we know nothing about it except just a glimpse of an idea. With أخذ ربك من بني آدم من ظهورهم ذريتهم أشهدهم على أنفسهم ولست بربكم. Allah is telling us, we have no idea, no information, but we know for sure that souls basically are created before our actual technical birth. But forget this, because I have no information about it. But we know the full details, the three later stages. Stage number two, which is we are living now, which is Hayat al-Dunya, this worldly life. It starts from the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angel to inject the soul in the womb of my mother and your mother. We start our being in this dunya as a living being in this dunya. That's why abortion is haram in Islam, because basically you are killing a human being. Killing literally a human being. So this is our beginning, and it ends by what we call death here, stage number two. Stage number three, it starts with alam al-barzakh. It starts with death when our eyes, فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. We have unrevealed the veil from now, and you have a very sharp sight, which means we started realizing some of the unseen, such as I will be witnessing the angel of death, which is part of al-ghayb now. The angel of death will be coming to me to take my soul. So I started observing, communicating, understanding with a new dimension now. Once this starts, we call this death. For many people, death is the end. For us, it's the real beginning. It's the real beginning. It's stage number three. Now, where we have what we call adab al-qabr and na'im al-qabr, the pleasure of the grave and the punishment of the grave. Then souls are kept there with two possibilities, with minor pleasure and minor punishment, up to the beginning and the commence of what we call the day of judgment as a first phase of al-akhirah, which is the day بيوم البعث والنشور, the resurrection and congregation for accountability. Now, why I'm saying that? If this is not clear in our minds, whatever we are discussing now is simply a waste of time. It's a waste of time. I'm just wasting your time and my time. But what's the meaning of be patient? Be patient for what? Because there's accountability. Be careful. Be careful from what? Don't be like them, because you might be exposed to fitna. How many Arabs and Muslims now, they are following the zalim against the mazlum? Now. Millions of them. Not hundreds or thousands. Millions of them. Every single regime, they have followers of millions. What we call them, al-muntafi'un ashab al-masalih. People of interest who are benefiting from whatever happens, regardless. Shedding blood, killing people, smashing people, ethnic cleansing, genocide. Am I benefited as a person? Am I having extra money in my bank account? If yes, let everyone go to hell. How many people of those we have in our countries? Millions. Millions. And most of them, the Quran expressed them as al-mala'a. قال الملأ من قوم فرعون. Look, most of the time, by the way, just to understand the story, why I'm just narrating some of them, Allah was not all the time speaking about just Fir'aun. Fir'aun is a person within a network. This network contains Haman and the Junud. Haman, now basically like a prime minister. The Junud, they are the security forces. Okay? So what about al-mala'? Okay, all the time. قال الملأ, قال الملأ, قال الملأ, قال الملأ, اتذروا, قال الملأ, قال الملأ. الملأ, people of authority, people of benefits, people of power surrounding the decision makers who are really could be the real decision makers. In our language now, people of power, people of money, people of banks, people of manufacturing weapons, people of big multinational companies who play with billions and trillions. Sometimes politicians are just merely puppets. Just puppets. People, this is the mala. So we have mala in every country now. In every nation we have mala to understand what's happening. 5,000 years ago, the same story. You have someone, you have a spokesperson, you have security forces, and you have mala all the time. Be careful. Don't let him. He will destroy. You know, they came to destroy. No, they did. They are just... Musa alayhi salam, he wanted just to leave Egypt. He said, just leave me alone. No. Because you have an idea that could destroy our idea. And if the people discovered your truth, we are lost. So we have to smash you. To do character assassination for you. You must destroy your image in the media. فبعث في المدائن حاشرين يأتوك بكل سحار عليم. We will challenge. We'll prove that they are wrong. So that's why we need to understand. At least we, just to gain the sabr that we are in the truth. And we need to understand from faith point of view. It's not always the case. Allah, may Allah forgive me for this expression. We don't control Allah. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And Allah does not do things according to our wishes. The fact that we are very angry now or very upset does not mean Allah, Ya Allah, خلاص. Allah will say, حاضر. He will change the sunnah al-kawniyah. No. Allah has, you know, universal divine laws in the universe. إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. Many of us, we are fighting Allah. Majority of us, by the way, on political level, on leadership level, on individual level, many of us, we are still fighting Allah. So it's not necessarily for the fact that some of us are sincere that Nasr immediately will come. No. But at least, if you believe you are from those sincere, and this is the best of your ability, be aware understanding how to gain the patience by at least understanding the rule of the game. At least. So in light of this introduction, I'm just adding part two. Last time we spoke about Surah Al-A'raf. It was a discussion between Fir'aun and Al-Mala and Musa alayhi salam. Today I'm picking and choosing from other places because the Quran is full of these stories. By the way, third of the Quran is Qasas stories. Can you imagine? Which means around 2,000 verse. 2,000. Which means, you ask yourself, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to give us all of these stories? Because every time you will find a similarity. And by the way, when Allah decided to choose the 25 prophets and messengers, they are out of 124,000. Which means it's nothing. It's nearly 1%. 1%, which is nothing, nearly nothing, just to give an idea. طيب, let's live with the Quran now in some of the places just to gain this kind of spiritual power to know that Allah, how Allah operates His universe. Now, one of the examples, and let me just remind you, I mentioned in previous times Ammar bin Yasir and Yasir and Sumayya, the first martyr. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was there. He was not able to do anything. قال اصبروا على ياسر فإن موعدكم الجنة. As one example, at a certain time. And another example, أصحاب الأخدود, the people of the trench, if you remember. قتل أصحاب النار ذات وهم عليها قعود, هم على ما يفعلون بالمشهود وما نقموا منهم. Okay. But Sheikh, they were killed. Okay. وما عند الله خير الأبرار. That's why we need the full image. We have death and then. Because as we always say, our story does not finish by death. We have a continuation. It's the beginning. If we are not aware of this, and by the way, mathematically, many Sahaba from liberal, atheistic, materialistic point of view are supposed to be crazy. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ It's not the case. No. When Suhaib radiallahu anhu, رَبِحَ الْبَيْءُ, you know, he was killed in Badr. And he was in our ward now. Suhaib was a multimillionaire. He was a very spoiled son of a multimillionaire family. He left everything. And when he passed away, they could not find an enough piece of cloth to cover his full body with his feet. If they covered his face, his feet were uncovered. If they covered his feet, his face was uncovered. And he was a son of a multimillionaire family. And he left everything. If you want to measure success by this, Mus'ab bin Umair, sorry, I was talking about Mus'ab. Sorry, I mix between Mus'ab and Suhaib. No, Suhaib, I mean Mus'ab bin Umair. Mus'ab bin Umair, he was a son of a multi. So he's a loser. He's not a loser. رَبِحَ الْبَيْعَ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ وَلَا تَقُولُ لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٌ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ. And by the way, there's a hadith sahih about the martyrs. They have a special karama, special honor. According to the hadith al-sahif, I'm not mistaken, it's in Bukhari. Their souls will be kept, قال في أجواف طير خضر يسرحون في الجنة. We don't know the why, how, I have no idea. Their souls will be kept within like a green special birds. They now are flying in the Jannah. They will keep just all the time. In a way, we don't know the how. The how is, unable to be comprehended by us. But وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا وَلَا تَقُولُوا. Don't tell them. They have a special life waiting for the beginning of the day of judgment. And I always keep reminding myself, because before I quote the quick example from the Quran, if someone thinks that protecting your honor or defending yourself or defending your family or your honor or your identity or your existence or your country is a waste of time, look to the non-believers. These examples, when I think about them, Russians who were communists, just to defend two cities, Stalingrad and Leningrad, they lost against the Nazis about 3 million. Russians in the Second World War, they lost around 20 plus millions to defend Russia. Communist Russia, 20 million non-believers, communists, to defend a piece of land. Type. Vietnamese against the Americans. Do you know, according to the BBC, in a documentary I witnessed direct by myself in 1997, according to the BBC, they claim that Americans, in the about 17 years of attacking Vietnam, they showered, literally, I'm quoting literally now, they showered Vietnam with 26 million tons of chemical weapons, which is equal in nowadays to 4 nuclear bombs. 26 million tons. Vietnamese, they were non-believers. And they lost between 3 to 5 million. And the end, they won. No context, no civilization, no roots, nearly no identity, yet they won because they believe that this is the right and they managed to stop the oppression against themselves. So when we think as a human being, I'm quoting now from completely another context now, not just the belief. I mean, when I speak an atheist, they don't believe in Jannah. Simply, they believe in their piece of land and that's it. Yet, they have the power. So what about the believer? So we need to reset our thinking when these things happen to us. Now, one of the quick examples. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ رُسُلًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ فَجَاءُوهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is a message from Allah about intiqam from the mujrim and nasr al-mu'min. Indeed, we sent before you, O Prophet, messengers, each of their own people, and they came to them with clear proofs, which means they were aware that this is the haqq. How many people do you know that the haqq is clear now? Millions, they know it. The reaction is something else. Clear proofs. قال فجاءوهم بالبينات. They refused. Clear proofs. حق باطل. You know. Don't you understand? Yes. This is international law. This is the peace. Everything is clear. Okay. What was the reason? I don't care. فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا. Then we inflicted punishment upon those who persisted in wickedness. Look. Persisted in wickedness. أجرموا. أجرام. Allah will punish. How? It's not my duty or your duty. We don't know. When? And how in this dunya and in the akhirah. For it is our duty to help the believers. Yeah, Sheikh, I mean, they are losing their lives. We go back to square number one. According to this, Sumayya is a loser. Suhaib is a loser. Mus'ab is a loser. Hashahum. Wal'iyadu billah. Most of the Sahaba, and I keep repeating, many of the Sahaba who passed away before the Badr, they did not witness Badr. Those who passed in Badr, they did not witness the conquer of Mecca. Those who passed before the conquer of Mecca, they did not witness what Abu Bakr did. They did not witness what Umar did. Does it mean they're a loser? A'udhu billah. Our story is much big. We are a people of a message. We are asked to be worshippers for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do our best. What Allah decides as a test for you and me, we do our best to do our test in our time. Once my time, your time is finished, and my accountability will be mine. And I will be out of the context. And Allah will continue testing the others. I'm not in charge of the world. I'm in charge of myself, yourself, to do. And that's why, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا ما آتاها. Allah will help me accountable for what He gave me. That's why I personally, I'm speaking with you now. Or otherwise, why to talk about this? Then everyone according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. Second example. وَإِذَا جَاءَتْهُمْ آيَةٌ قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ حَتَّى نُؤْتِيَ مِثْلَ مَا أُوْتِيَ رُسُلُ اللَّهِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ حَيْثُ يَجْعَلُ رِسَالَتَهُ سَيُصِيبُ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا صَغَارٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَعَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَمْكُرُونَ. Look now. سيصيب الذين أجرموا صغار عند الله وعذاب شديد بما كانوا يمكرون. Whenever a sign comes to them, I repeat, I'm talking about the proofs, clear proofs and signs. This is the genius, divine genius of the Quran. Allah uses something that is applicable on every time and then. Sign, clear signs, proofs, it's clear. Now nearly 99.9% of every single person on earth knows what's the haqq and what's the batil. They know in terms of the knowledge. But next, something else. Whenever a sign comes to them, they say, we will never believe until we receive what Allah's messengers received. Allah knows best where to place His message. The wicked will soon be overwhelmed by humiliation from Allah and the severe punishment for their evil plots. They are just making excuses. They know, but they making excuse. طيب. Third one, and I finish, inshallah, my message with it. From Surah Al-Mutaffifin. And this is the most important for me now, to understand the mentality of those people the wicked people who are using their power now by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to oppress others. Just to understand the psychological mentality and what will happen to them compared with the oppressed. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَضْحَكُونَ. Indeed, the wicked used to laugh at the believers. Take it in a general meaning now. You know? Look, the wicked, they were laughing against the oppressed. What did they tell you? That's because they have the power. They were laughing at them. What is applicable on an individual is applicable metaphorically on a nation level. It's the same. The same, but different aspects. But the idea, the rule is the same. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ. Now, wink to one another whenever they pass by. Look at them, you know, look down to them, wink. Yes. You know, those idiots. And by the way, what's happening now is very similar to what used to happen, somehow, psychologically speaking. That's to understand the psychology of the oppressor. What was happening with the Nazis, Hitler? What was the core point? They were believing in the superiority of their race. True or false? I mean, Nazism was based on what? The superiority of the German race. Which is what? And by the way, they were strong believers in Darwinism. البقاء للأصلح. We are better. So by default, you don't deserve to exist, rest the others. You don't deserve. What? But I've done nothing to you. Who told you that you need to do something for me to have the right to get rid of you? Get my point? So the idea is very dangerous. It's not just someone has done something bad or wrong. No. There is an initial racist superiority. Whatever comes to my mind, it's my right. Whatever I decide is mine, it's mine. What? But it's not yours. I decide what's mine. This kind of superiority. You need to understand the idea of إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يَضْحَكُونَ. They were laughing at them. وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ يَتَغَامَزُونَ. Wink to one another when they pass by. وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ. And when they return to their own people, they would return jesting. وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ. And when they saw the faithful, they would say, these people are truly astray. Who are the astray? The oppressed. Why? Because simply they have the power against them, and that's it. This is exactly what Nazis they were doing. They were trying to kill millions of people around them because they believe that they are superior, and that's it. That's it. So it's a very dangerous. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues, وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. Even though they were not sent as keepers over the believers, who gave you this right? Allah is the one who has the right upon everyone. Allah is the decision maker who deserves to be in this place or that place. It's not mine or yours. That's why we need to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once a group of nation or people, they have the ultimate power, they will act as if they are God. But أعوذ بالله in just, you know, this kind of like the Greek gods, okay? You have God of evil and God of bad things. And God, this is how they act, unfortunately. وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ. Even though they were not sent as keepers of the believers. فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ. But on that day, the believers will be laughing at the disbelievers. I need to highlight this. It's either I believe or I don't believe. فاليوم, Allah talking about the day of judgment. Now, the day of مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَضْحَكُونَ. Those believers will be laughing at the disbelievers. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ. Seated upon their couches, they are looking around. You know, they look. هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. The believers will be asked, have the disbelievers not been paid back for what they used to do? Allah will let the angels or by himself directly will be asking the believers, هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. Have I fulfilled my promise to you to take revenge from the oppressed people? Yes or no? You know? This is a big thing, by the way, when you think about it, because this is the idea, the accountability. Unless we believe in accountability, why not to join the oppressor? Because he's the strong. And let's finish the whole story. By the way, mathematically speaking, why not to join the strong even if he's an oppressor? Why not mathematically? If this is your interest and you will live happily as they claim, why not? Simply the answer, because we fear Allah. Because Allah said no. That's it. If anyone can compete Allah, let him do it. We can't. We have to admit. This is the meaning of submission. Submission means what? I'm admitting that I am the weak part of the equation and Allah has the ultimate power. It's math, by the way. If وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, God forbid, if anyone thinks that he can be a competitor to Allah, let him go and fight. Yeah, تفضل. We will follow you if you can. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدْ فَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْعَابِدِينَ. If you can prove that there is a son, Allah is teaching Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Tell those who believe that God has a son. If you can prove that there is a son, I, Muhammad, will be the first worshipper. Prove to me that Allah is so weak to need a wife or a son. So, هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. The believers will be asked, have the disbelievers not been paid back for what they used to do? بَلَا يَا رَبِّ. We believe that they will be paid back, inshallah. But the most important thing, not to be close to them and not to be part of them, not to be backing them, or not to be silent if we can do something or otherwise. In the Fir'auna وهامانا وجنودهما كانوا, they are all one package because it's a distribution of evil between these groups. Any one of them will be part of the problem. أسأل الله أن يعيذنا. أقول قولي هذا, استغفر الله لي ولكم فيفوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا, من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا كريم, واغفر لنا وتجاوز عنا اللهم يا رب العالمين. اغفر لنا ولوالدينا والدي والدينا أصحاب الحقوق والواجبات علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم منزل الكتاب ومجري السحاب وسريع الحساب وهازم الأحزاب يا رب العالمين. زلزل الأرض من تحت أقدام المعتدين المغتصبين يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا عزيز ويا كريم, عليك بالظالمين ومن عاونهم ومن ناصرهم, اللهم عليك بهم فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا رب العالمين. اللهم أرسل عليهم جندا من عندك من فوقهم ومن تحتهم وعن أيمانهم وشمائلهم, وخذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر. وارحم الشهداء يا الله وتقبلهم عندك, وكن مع الضعفاء والمجروحين. واغفر لنا تقصيرنا في نصرة إخوان المستضعفين. آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.